I always wanted to be a doctor. My dad's a doctor.
Okay, sit up. I promise this won't hurt.
Actually, a vet. Dad's office was in the basement of our home growing up. It still is. He took care of small animals mostly. You know, dogs, cats, birds. Treating livestock was his dream. But we lived in Providence, Rhode Island. Not a lot of wildebeest running around. I remember as a kid, loving nothing more than returning the patients to their families. It was the look on their faces that really got me. So full of appreciation, relief, love. Not exactly the response I get these days.
Does this look like Courtney Cox? I told you I wanted Courtney Cox, not Jennifer Aniston. Courtney's nose is narrow at the tip. Jennifer's is wide. I wanted narrow.
Open up the LA phone book and you'll find more than 100 cosmetic surgeons. One of them is me.
Rooms 1, 2, and 3 are waiting to see you. Mike Roth called. He has some questions about his pectoral implants. Marjorie Cram decided yes on collagen, no on lipo. Veronica Booker wants you to know she loves her new breasts.
I almost forgot. Your mother called. You missed the dress rehearsal.
Oh, no.
She wants to make sure you're not missing the wedding as well. Should I call her?
No, I'll do it. Just let me see these patients. Who's up first?
Mr. Tummy.
A little liposuction, I can get rid of that banana roll.
I actually started medical school wanting to be a pediatrician. I mean, what could be more noble than taking care of sick children? I had it all planned. Boston, private practice, an office in the basement of my house. Just like my dad. Then I met sweet baby James. The next thing I knew, I was assisting in the OR.
Sutures?
The surgery took under 2 hours, less time than it takes to see a movie. I kept thinking what this little boy's life would have been like if not for us, if not for plastic surgery. It was incredible. It was like magic.
It is magic.
It's actually a rewarding job. I usually bring patients happiness.
I love them. And I love you.
And sometimes, I uncover their sadness.
It was supposed to make him fall in love with me.
And sometimes, though not as often as I like, I get to do something magical. And just like when I was a little girl, it's the look on their faces that still gets me. It reminds me of growing up and of Providence. And for a brief moment, I become my father's daughter again.
All around me are all of your hearts. I still don't know how you got me through the mat. Then you tell me that even angels fall. Sometimes when it's quiet, I can hear you call. When I think of your smile, you make me home. It could be a million miles, and you make me home. The sound of your voice, you make me home.
Thomas Wolfe said you can't go home again. Sometimes a daughter doesn't have a choice.
Mom, I told you I would be there tomorrow.
You said today.
No, I said that my plane leaves today and that I arrive in Providence tomorrow.
You broke your sister's heart.
Oh, please, I'm sure Joni didn't even notice.
She noticed. So did your father. You think it's every day your sister gets married?
Hey, Mom, I'm coming up to a tunnel here.
I hope you got your hair cut.
I can't hear you.
We're having a makeup girl come to the house beforehand.
Look, we're about to disconnect.
It won't kill you to wear a little makeup.
Oh.
criticizing me is like breathing for my mother. She can't stop.
Baby, I know how hard it is for you.
I just don't know why I let her push my buttons.
Because she's the one who installed them. Ooh.
Jerry, I can't. I gotta pack.
Why don't you let me give you something to remember me by?
Ooh. Jerry.
Take a later flight.
I can't. Maybe.
Yellow. Patra on through.
Jerry and I have been living together for 6 months.
Hey, we still on?
He's an agent.
How about Spago?
A lot of his clients are patients of mine.
Great. Yeah. All right, I'll see you in 20.
Hey, what about the airport?
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I can't. It's a premiere party. I have to go. Come on. You understand, don't you?
Yeah, sure. No, you know, you're my boyfriend. You should drive me to the airport.
Oh, come on, honey. That's why God invented limos. I wish I could go back east with you, though.
Then why don't you?
Because it's pilot season. You know what I'd really like?
Besides someone younger, taller, and blonde? No. What?
To meet your mother.
She'd love you.
I'd tell her that the sun rises and sets with her daughter.
My daughter's a plastic surgeon in Los Angeles. She inflated that Baywatch bimbo.
You must be very proud.
Well?
You look lovely.
If you were going to the hooker's ball.
Mom?
Margaret, for God's sakes, do something with that excuse for a waist.
Mother!
How did I let your sister talk me into that color?
Well, it is Joni's wedding.
No, dear. It's my wedding. She's just the bride. I'm dying for a cigarette.
I thought you gave it up.
So does your father. Oh, that better be the caterer. I'm having serious hors d'oeuvre concerns. Hello? Give me the address. I'm on my way. Gotta run. I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
Joni's at the emergency room. And Margaret, try to invent a little cleavage while I'm gone, will you?
What? Look, her name is Joan Hansen.
One sec. Do you have insurance?
No.
Do you belong to an HMO?
No.
Then you have a problem.
Damn right. Every time I spit up, it's green. You have nice eyes.
Thank you. Hansen. She's being examined as we speak.
Who's the attending?
Have a seat, Cinderella. As soon as I hear something, you'll be the next to know.
My damn battery ran out.
No, Philippe. My patience is running out. No more surprises with the hors d'oeuvres, or there'll be a surprise in your check.
How hard is it to wrap 1,000 baby hot dogs in pastry dough? Dr.
Raymond, MIT. I'm thinking.
There's Joni.
She's pregnant.
Of course she's pregnant. Why do you think she's getting married?
Sid, you made it!
You did not tell me she was pregnant. Of course I told you.
No, you didn't. Hey, Joni, you're pregnant. You didn't tell me.
Of course I told you.
No, you didn't.
Anywho, I was having these phony baloney contractions. Something they called them...
Braxton Hicks.
Yeah, Sydney, what don't you know?
Anything about hors d'oeuvres?
Joni needs to stay off her feet and get plenty of rest in the next 24 hours. If you need me, I'm on call at the St. Clair Street Clinic.
That's impossible. She's getting married.
She'll do it.
Sid Hansen. I'm Helen Reynolds. We studied organic chem together at Brown.
Yeah.
You threw up during the final.
Sid always put a lot of pressure on herself to succeed.
Yes, it was all self-inflicted.
My sister's a plastic surgeon. She just flew in from Hollywood. She bobbed Tori Spelling's beak.
You must be...
proud. Yes, so proud I could burst.
Glad to see your family.
That too.
one fine day, you'll look at me, and then you'll know our love was meant to be. One fine day, you're gonna want me for
Kyle!
Your
you just shaved 5 seconds off your personal best! That's great!
The arms I long for will open wide. Then you'll be proud to have me right by your side. One fine day.
Kyle, don't stop.
Kyle, what are you doing? Kyle.
Hello. Hello. You get good reception with that dish?
Good, puppy.
Joni, I can't be in two places at once.
Oh, you look...
jet-lagged. What time is it?
Time to get moving. We're already behind schedule. What is that?
That's one of Dad's, I guess.
Oh, I swear to God, it's like living in a kennel.
Dad's a vet, Mom. It is a kennel.
Well, when you find Dr. Doolittle, tell him we're meeting with the photographer in 1 hour, with or without his son.
Robbie's not here yet?
Well, if he wants to live to see his own funeral, he'd better be. There we go. Oh, you know,
you could have napped in Robbie's room.
That's disgusting. Hanson Veterinary Clinic. No, this is Sid. Oh, hi, Mr. Haber. Oh, yes. Proud. Very proud. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Yeah, let me get him. Dad? Hey, found your brother. Oops. Just before he crossed the border. You, get down in there. There you go. Nice. Dad?
Well, look who's here. Dr. Hanson.
Hi, Dad.
Sid. Say hello to Mrs. Bradley.
Hi, Mrs. Bradley.
She looks just like her mother.
Mm-hmm. I do?
Wiggles says you're feeding her a high-ash diet, Mrs. Bradley. Pretty soon she's not going to be able to pee.
Gorgeous and a plastic surgeon to boot. Is it true you sucked out Stallone's extra chin?
Yes.
You must be very proud.
Wiggles' bladder is going to explode like the Hindenburg. Can you live with that, Mrs. Bradley? I couldn't.
I don't know how Linda puts up with you, Jim.
Me neither. Change her diet.
My love to the very pregnant bride.
Mr. Haber is waiting on line one.
Haber the Schnauzer, Haber the Siamese, or Haber the Toucan?
Haber the Kibble King? Said he won't deliver until you pay him for last month. Did you sign the check, Daddy?
Joni handles the books.
You're kidding.
Well, she was a little crazy with her allowance. But, she's maturing. Getting married, having a baby.
No one told me she was pregnant.
I did.
No, you didn't. So do you like him?
He fishes.
For compliments?
Scrod, off the coast. Pretty good business. Your mom can't get past the smell.
It's always something.
I'll say. First she put her foot down, said Joni would get married over her dead body. Then she reconsidered. Now she says this wedding is killing her.
Dad, Mom said to hurry.
Pictures in an hour, with or without Robbie. Go.
Bye.
Well, Haber, how long have we been doing business?
Your room hasn't changed since high school.
Robbie's either. Like a museum. The only thing missing are the velvet ropes in the gift shop. I feel like a hippo.
You look beautiful.
For a hippo in a wedding dress. I can't believe I'm getting married today. It seems like just yesterday you were teaching me which end of the tampon is up.
Hey, is this him?
Yeah.
It's cute. What's he like?
Richie, he's nice.
Nice?
And moral.
Nice and moral. Who are you marrying, the Pope?
Oh, don't be silly. Richie's not religious.
You're not settling, are you, Joni?
What do you mean?
I mean, do you love him?
I think so. But Mom hates him.
Mom hates everyone, equally.
No. She said point blank, you'll marry Captain Ahab over my dead body.
Yeah, well, it looks to me like she's thrown herself into making this a perfect day for you.
For her.
I want the house in the background. I know the light is better towards the road, but make it work.
Uh-huh.
Finally! Now, I want every combination and permutation that you can shoot of the five immediate family.
How many is that, Sid?
Robbie, for the love of Mike, why aren't you wearing a helmet?
I don't own one. Who's Mike, and why do I want his love?
Hey, big sis. How's life in the fast lane?
You're gonna end up an organ donor.
Oh, my God, Joni, you're pregnant.
You didn't know either?
Get real. It's all Mom's talked about for the last 6 months. Hey, Pop!
Hail, hail. The gang's all here. Robbie, my boy.
Dad!
Oh! Where'd you get the bike?
Investment dividends. Dad, I bought it.
Stole it,
Joni.
Group shot.
You look beautiful.
Oh, funny. All right. Everyone smile.
For family. Damn it.
Keep smiling. Keep walking. I know what they're thinking. She's a doctor. She's still single. She must be gay. Keep smiling.
Hey.
I forgot to pee. I should have peed. Oh, I gotta pee.
Thank you, darling.
I don't know what happened. One minute she's just standing there, and then the next she's down for the count.
It's okay, Mom. It'll be okay.
She had to be the center of attention. I knew it.
Shut up, Joni.
You shut up.
Somebody get some water, please.
Is she gonna be okay, sis?
Dad, get an ambulance.
Somebody call 911. Somebody call 911.
Come on, Mom. I wish I could say that my years of medical training paid off, that I saved my mother's life as easily as I have many others. But life and careers are fragile. Neither should be taken for granted. Mom died at the church. The wedding was canceled. Mom was right about one thing. Joni wouldn't get married over her dead body. We tried to make the best of a very difficult situation. I think Mom would have appreciated the spirit of economy.
Hi.
I have done some time in Silicon Valley, and I'm telling you, the moment is ripe for my new software company. You know, I just need someone who can front my product with a little bit of intelligence and some sex appeal. I mean, someone just like you.
Really?
Yeah. I'll tell you what. Why don't you give it some thought, Tracy? I mean, I think you are perfect for this job. Sid, can you wait up a sec?
Working the wake, Robbie?
Give me a break. Just trying to keep my mind off Mom. Can I ask you a med question?
I'm not writing you a script for painkillers.
You can do that?
No.
How come every single time I come into this house for more than a couple hours, I start to, like, hyperventilate?
I don't know. I'm a surgeon, not a shrink.
Hey, Sid, have you ever considered, like, going national with this plastic surgery racket? You know, maybe making an infomercial? Huh? You know, some seed money, a couple of thou. I just have to find some people who know something about film.
Robbie!
What?
Where's Joni?
She's upstairs resting.
How about Dad?
Sid, you've been his daughter about 30 years. I think you know where you can find him.
Dad, there are a lot of your friends and family waiting upstairs to pay their respects.
He's been having seizures all morning. I can't figure out why.
Dad.
Wish I could take a family history. Most of the time, these little fellows love to talk, but this one's taken the fifth.
Please come upstairs, Daddy.
Neurological disorders, tricky business. If only I had the proper technology, I could make a diagnosis.
Dad, it's just a damn dog.
Forgive her. She's only human.
Where are you going?
Out.
What about the wake?
I can make a damn bit of difference. Your mother's still dead.
Sid, I'm bleeding.
Excuse me. St. Cloud's Family Clinic, can you help me, please? St. Clair's Family Clinic, I'm sorry. How can I help you? Oh, excuse me, can you hold on one more second? Thanks. Yes, sir.
Sid? Joni and the baby are fine. There's no tear in the placenta.
Thank you.
Okay. You hanging in there?
I'm a little dazed and confused.
I'm sorry about your mother.
Thanks.
She was one of the few people who could always make me laugh. Never afraid to speak her mind.
Or drive me nuts. You know, when I became a doctor, I wanted to make a difference. I couldn't even save my own mother. Some difference.
Annabella, the Lord hath provided.
Not through you, he hasn't.
Anna comes here every day to pray.
Pray for an exodus that these doctors leave and let me have my church back.
City was going to tear St. Clair's down and build a garage, but I convinced them we needed more space to treat people than park cars.
Hey.
Hey.
Joni, call me if there's any changes or if you have any questions.
Okie dokie. Thank you.
Are you one of them?
I'm a plastic surgeon.
Oh, God help us all.
On.
I'm looking for Mom's engagement ring. She promised it to me, you know, in case I ever got married.
Oh, you're getting married?
No. Are you?
Robbie.
You're a parasite, Robbie.
Joni.
Do you have any idea how long probate can take?
Oh, they teach you that in jail?
Really appreciate it if you'd stop hurting my feelings.
Robbie, you had your feelings surgically removed years ago. What's gonna happen to us, Sid?
I can't stay, Joni. I've got a job to get back to.
Why are you always running away?
What are you talking about?
When I was six, you ran away from home. I couldn't stop crying.
I hid in the Barnett's backyard. I got hungry. I was back in 40 minutes.
I gave you my toothbrush.
And I returned it.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Whatever.
Oh.
Oh, I hate that.
I hate that word. It's patronizing and condescending.
No more than you using your career as an excuse to leave the family. Whatever. You know, it's my life that's taken a full Luganus into the toilet. Mom's gone. I'm gonna have a baby. Who's supposed to take care of Dad?
He'll be fine.
Then who's supposed to take care of me?
Problem is neurological. This'll spot it.
Like the idea of a dog getting a CAT scan.
One life is as important as any other.
I'm leaving for LA tonight.
Remember when your cat, Sam, ran away? You were inconsolable. 2 months later, he was back scratching at the door as if nothing had ever happened.
We're not talking about an animal I forgot to feed when I was six, Dad.
Happens all the time. People fly away, leave their unwanted pets on the curb like a broken-down couch for the Goodwill. Breaks a little guy's hearts.
I came to say goodbye, Dad.
Pets are a full-time responsibility. You never understood that.
No, but see, what I do understand is that you are hiding. You are ignoring the family, and you are in complete denial about Mom. Do you hear me, Dad?
You woke him up. Do we have to start again?
I'm afraid so.
That's great.
I didn't mean to...
Oh, sure. You came to say goodbye. Well, I'm good at that. Goodbye is all I ever get to say to you. Goodbye. Go. Please.
Fine.
Fine.
Rooms 1, 2, and 3 are full. Craig Chadway called. He's concerned about his upcoming penile implant. Natasha Newport loves her new thighs. And Judge Rex on us.
I like your nose.
I hate it.
Why?
That bump.
What bump?
Come on. The one on my nose.
It gives you character.
Sure, if I were Streisand or Gretzky.
What do you see when you look in the mirror, besides your nose?
Not much.
Really? Because I see a beautiful 16-year-old girl with her whole life ahead of her, bump or no bump. Besides, you don't have a deviated septum. There's no medical necessity for surgery. Why take the risk?
But I didn't
No
get
buts.
It.
Trust me, I'm doing us both a favor.
Hello? Jerry? Jerry?
Hey, Jerry? Home, honey.
Oh, thank God the week from hell is over. I'm so glad to be home, babe. Jerry?
Jerry.
Oh, my God.
I can explain.
And yet I don't care. Oh, my God.
Sydney!
Shut up, Jerry.
Sydney,
he's
not
a bitch.
What you think, Sid. Sydney, wait. Wait. Sydney. Sydney, wait. Please. Look, I can't explain.
I'm salivating with anticipation.
Look. He's a new client.
There are seminal moments when it becomes painfully clear how much you can hate your life. Today was one of them. I took a leave of absence from my practice, went to the airport, and waited for divine guidance.
Final call for standby passenger Rosa. Final call, standby passenger Rosa.
Who said God isn't a practical joker?
Sid? Sid Hansen. It's me, Kyle Moran. Homeroom, South Providence High.
Oh, the jock.
Well, that was then. I tore my rotator cuff playing AAA in Pawtucket. Bye-bye baseball.
Oh, sorry.
No, hey, it's life. Can't play kids' games forever.
Still sculling?
Well, not since my shoulder gave out, but...
Right.
How'd you know I used to row?
Lucky guess, I guess. You should really get re-examined. There's new orthopedic procedures that, well, they'll make you as good as new.
How'd you know that?
I'm a doctor.
A doctor? Wow. Always were the brainiac. Shy, but cute. Me, I never left Providence. Never really wanted to.
Trust me, the outside world is overrated.
Listen, I'd give you a ride into town, but...
You're meeting someone.
Yeah.
Right. Well, you take care of yourself, Kyle.
Yeah, you too, Sid. Maybe I'll see you again sometime.
Many's the time I've been mistaken. And many times confused. Yes, and I've often felt forsaken and certainly misused. Oh, but I'm all right, I'm all right. Just weary to my bones. Still, you don't expect to be bright and bon vivant so far away from home. So far away.
Is your first time in Providence?
No. I grew up here a long time ago.
You won't recognize the place. The mayor's renovated the whole downtown. When's the last time you were home?
Yesterday.
Where do you live now?
Los Angeles.
Oh, what do you do?
Plastic surgeon.
No fooling.
No fooling. Can you make a right here, please?
Hey, those Jenny McCarthy boobs. You think you could do that for my missus?
No.
I didn't think so.
Here you go. Keep the change.
Returning Joni's toothbrush?
I missed Providence.
Yeah, right.
It might help if you use a key.
Yeah, everybody's a critic.
Yeah, well, it's genetic.
Hey, Sid. Remember that grand that I was hawking you for?
I am not doing an infomercial, Robbie.
I'm way past that.
Good.
Truth is that I'm in a short-term cash flow squeeze.
I'll leave you a check.
I'll pay you back.
Yeah, sure.
Ta-da!
Will you please be careful, Robbie?
Yeah, I know. Wear a helmet.
Yeah, that's the least of it.
Mom's engagement ring. Hold on to it for me, all right?
Just in case you ever get married.
Oh, Helen, thank God you're here.
No, it's me, Sid.
Sid?
Hey.
Hey.
I'm having the baby.
Well, let's get you to the hospital.
No, no, I mean, I'm having the baby now. Oh, my God!
Come on, Joni. It's okay. One more push, honey. Good girl, good girl.
Hey.
Hey. That's good. I'm dying, and he's doing fluff and fall.
No, no. We need warm towels. Come on, take my place.
Okay. Here we go again.
Okay, Richie, I want you to help Joni focus and help her with the breathing.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Good girl, Joni. That's it. That's it. Come on. Good girl.
Stop it! That stuff doesn't work! Oh, God, it hurts so much!
Come on, Joni. You were always a strong one in the family. You can do it, honey.
What do you see?
I see the baby's head starting to crown. Joni, there's meconium in the amniotic fluid.
Is that good?
We need to get this baby out as soon as we can, so that next contraction, I want you to push with everything you've got, okay, Joni. Everything okay, you've got, okay?
Okay.
Here we go. Oh, here we go.
Good girl.
Ah! Come on. That's it. All right, Stop pushing. You can, all right? Because the cord is wrapped around the baby's neck.
Oh, God!
It's all right.
Oh,
it's okay.
God.
It's okay. Oh, easy does it. Easy does it.
Oh,
wait. Here we go. Nice and easy. Just don't push, all right? Here we go.
Okay,
let me
okay,
slip it off.
Okay. Oh, God.
There we go. There we go. Okay.
Okay,
okay. Now, honey. Okay. Now, last push. Come on. Last one. Almost there.
On.
One more. Come on. That's it.
No!
There you go.
Oh, God.
The girl.
Oh, is she okay?
She's beautiful. She's perfect. Yeah, just let me wrap her up here, nice and warm. There we go. Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, no.
You want to cut the cord?
I know what you're doing, Sid.
I'd be honored.
Maybe when Joni gets back on her feet, you'd like to come work at the clinic.
That'd be great.
It's not glamorous, but...
You practice medicine.
So could you. Just a thought.
No, it's a good thought. How you feeling?
Sore.
I bet. Where's Richie?
Out to sea.
Don't worry, Joni. We're gonna get you married.
Somehow that doesn't matter right now. Sid, what you did was a miracle.
Man, you did all the hard work. I was along for the ride.
Do you believe in the afterlife?
I barely believe in this life.
So where do you think Mom is?
In heaven, bumming a smoke.
Finagling a room upgrade.
I think she's here and incredibly proud of you and her new granddaughter.
And you. You were her favorite.
Oh, yeah.
You're a lot like her.
Thank you.
No, I mean that in a good way. Go there. I think she's done.
I'll take her. Thanks.
Oh.
Hello. Hello.
I love you, Sid.
Get some rest, kiddo.
How's Joni doing?
She's a natural. I think she's gonna be a terrific mother. How's the little guy?
All the tests were negative.
That's great.
How's my granddaughter?
Topped off.
full of milk.
You were a good eater. Good eater, but a lousy sleeper.
Still am.
And a bundle of energy. Used to run your mother ragged all day, so I got the night shift. 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, I'd be walking back and forth, my eyes slits, yours wide open, full of fire.
Battle of wills.
And neither of us would give in. But I was determined. Figured if I just kept going, I could outlast you. Most times I did, but there were nights we saw the sunrise. You were so stubborn.
Like father, like daughter. Hmm.
She has your mother's nose.
Mom didn't even have her own nose, Dad. I fixed it, remember?
I miss her.
Me too.
You gonna be staying in Providence?
I don't know.
Then you'll be going home to Los Angeles.
Maybe.
We should go.
Yeah. Yeah. You gonna be okay?
Sure. Sure. Go. Joni and the baby need you. Robbie needs you, but he doesn't even know it.
What about you, Dad?
I don't want you to go.
Ask me to stay. Come on, Dad. Come on, you can ask me.
Please stay.
Meeting.